You know my twin's gonna deliver a classic.
What's up, guys? I just went to LA and here's how that went. Starting in Dallas, I actually ran into Jamar Chase. He was just in front of me in line for DFW TSA. He had huge sunglasses and a big old hat. Like, he was moving so incognito. But I watched like 150 plus hours of NFL Red Zone last season, so bro, you're not getting past me. Like, I literally recognized him off the lower third of his face. He was cool though. We got a quick pic and then I caught my flight to LA. My LA trip actually lined up perfectly with the Rose Bowl. And if you don't know what the Rose Bowl is, it's basically a super scale vintage flea market with furniture, handmade goods, and of course, clothes. There were so many vintage booths set around the entirety of the Rose Bowl Stadium, but it was pretty commonplace to see vintage bands slash graphic tees and vintage crop jackets. It was interesting though. I really like seeing people with different styles. And I was low-key tempted to ask people what they were wearing for the vid. I asked this one guy, he was like kinda old and he had this crazy Chrome Hearts jacket. It was like the normal biker jacket that you kinda see a lot, but instead of black suede under the silver cross patches, it was purple suede. It was pretty insane. He said no video, so I just scrapped the entire idea.
Do you prefer like any particular wash of denim, like dark, light, normal?
I like the gray one.
The gray one? This one's cool. This is kind of close to like that anthracite color on the Acnes. They have more on this side too. Like, but this is like some real military. You don't rock with that real tree hoodie. This zip up is kinda.
It's a 4G.
Yeah. I can hold your jacket for you, bro. I think it's too long. Single stitch, light blue. Pretty cool. Hey, how much is this?
80.
Thanks, dude.
This one's like.
If there wasn't stain and reps.
At this point, the homie Grant pulled up. Grant's been to the Rose Bowl, I think he said like two times before, so this was his third time. He low-key a veteran. He told us last time he was here, he actually copped one of these handmade leather belts. And I personally really like the white leather belt, but I had to hold off. And in my next pickups video, y'all are gonna see this Chrome Hearts belt that I special ordered for my 22nd birthday. Here's what some of those vintage jackets I mentioned earlier look like. We kept exploring after that because the Rose Bowl is really circular, so we just kept walking around in a circle. But after another lap, we just had to dip out. We just got out the Rose Bowl. I picked up this t-shirt, this vintage Apple tee, but it was pretty cool. Just like an overdose amount of vintage tees. And it's like literally gonna be impossible to look through everything. So I found the Apple tee that I've been looking for on eBay for like the past few weeks. So I'm excited. After the Rose Bowl, we decided to hit up the Row LA. First up was Bodega. Bodega is always cool, and I low-key didn't even know where we were going at first.
The card and it just went down to 300, random. Like, they went down 100 bucks, and I was like,
good money when it first came out.
I
I didn't even know they made a yellow one. The yellow one is low-key not bad. These are cool. I got the Nicole McLaughlin version there. I was thinking about getting these, but I got these instead.
We got hungry, so we moved down the road to Smorgasburg. And if you aren't familiar, Smorgasburg is a pop-up where you get to choose from over 80 different food vendors. We all got acai bowls. Well, they weren't cups. Also, another thing to keep in mind is that it's only open on Sundays from 12 to 4. After that, we headed down to Dover Street Market, LA. DSM carries so many brands.
Pick these up in black.
And there was just so much in the store. And it was pretty calm till I found the Balenci section. And they had this insane, like, 4-in-1 jacket. Yeah, it weighed like 10 pounds. It's low-key an item for sure.
Just got out of DSM LA. Picked up some memorabilia. Employees were mad friendly, so it was dope.
I did also flick up a bit in the store, and you know you made it when the DSM employees are telling you your fit is ridiculously hard. After that, we hit H. Lorenzo, and to be honest, the door was the coolest part about this whole experience. The store had a sale going on. I think it was 50% off everything, but it was low-key only fire if you were a woman. So we ended up dipping out of there pretty quickly. All right, then we went to Acne Studios. I flew to LA with the intention of copying the Anthracite 2023Fs. I just had to try them on to know what size I should get. The Acne stores are always designed really nicely. I kind of get why people always flick up in them. I wasn't really feeling the way these fit in a 48, so I asked them to bring in a 1981. I wasn't too sold yet, so I asked them to bring in a 50 2023, and these didn't really fit my body like I wanted them to. I tried on a 52 1981 just in case I had to size up again. They only had these fugly tie-dye pair. After that, I tried on the 50s and the 1981s one more time, just to be sure. And yeah, I bought them. The wash on these is really nice. I remember trying a 48 in the 1981s in New York City last winter. I tried on the painted pair, the screen printed digital denim. I didn't really like the way the 48 sat on my body. And I was low key deterred from the 1981 silhouette just because like it really fit like trash. So if you wanna try 1981s, you should definitely size up at least once. Next, we headed literally across the street to Maxfield. They carry Guidi, Chrome, Rick, and other designers like that. I found this insane snakeskin jacket there. The hand feel was pretty nice, and the way it was constructed, you could just tell that this was a quality garment. But while I was making this video, I actually noticed that the tag said Zampe di Gallo, which means chicken feet. And then I zoomed in a little bit on the Maxfield tag, and I saw that it said this is the rooster jacket. And if it really is made of 100 chicken feet, like, I don't even know what to say, I'm speechless. They also had this insane turquoise dial Air King with the Chrome Hearts band, and it was paved with diamonds. And it's only a light 135 bands. What, you don't got it like that? Neither do I, so. After that, the crew was a little thirsty, so if you're in LA, you gotta hit Erewhon. And if you don't know, Erewhon is basically a super, super overpriced LA grocery store. I think it's like really popping right now because of TikTok and their recent collabs with Balenciaga and CPFM, but we got it for free because of the free Erewhon method. I wanted to get a smoothie at first, but the smoothie line was long as hell. So I just got a pineapple dream juice.
Pretty good, but $13, I don't know. It tastes like orange juice. Like literally just orange juice.
Now I was getting hungry though. We went to Kazunori for some fire hand rolls. Kazu was goated. I've never had hand rolls before, so I decided to try the 6-roll combo. And the one I preferred the most was definitely the scallop hand roll. It was bussin', bussin'. We drove past the Oscars as well. and the guard low-key held the back gate open a little too easy, like, you know? My intrusive thoughts were low-key telling me to just sneak into this mug, like, on some hitman type. But after your meal, if you don't get a sweet treat with the boys, are you really living? But yeah, we hit Oako Bing. I don't know if I said that correctly. The mango treat was super bust. I highly recommend. We started out today with our Chrome Hearts LA appointment. If you ever go to Chrome LA, bro, the security guard, he's just so troll. Like, buddy had jokes. You can't film in Chrome either, and we were also basically getting super shadowed by the SA. Not in a y'all might steal type of way, but like, bro was just mad friendly and he would just conversate with us. And I remember at one point he was like, oh, let me not interrupt y'all's shopping experiences. So I thought he would stop shadowing us, but nah, bro just went stealth mode and kept stalking us. But don't get me wrong, he was a super chill guy and he's not as snobby and pretentious as you'd expect a Chrome Hearts employee to be. The store was furnished nicely and I really, really loved the dining table. It was just this long ebony table with two ebony chairs at the long ends. And the ebony was carved with Chrome Hearts signature motifs. And in the middle of this long table is a bouquet of white roses inside of a Chrome Hearts vase. It was so beautiful. It was so inspiring. And I low-key need a setup like that in my home one day. However, the stock in Chrome LA was pretty dry. They had a lot of Matty Boy Bulbul, but if you're wearing Matty Boy Chrome, and the coolest thing they had in there, in my opinion, was probably a couple of Chrome Hearts Rolies. I think they had a Chrome Hearts Cartier Tank watch in there as well. It's just interesting to see these iconic watches, the bracelets replaced with a Chrome Hearts bracelet. I don't know, I just think that's hard. Our SA was telling us about his fave celebrity encounters. And then my personal favorite celeb that he mentioned was definitely Young Thug. He was telling us how Young Thug made an appointment like a regular person and just showed up, waited in line outside the store, and they're like, dude, are you serious? You're Thug, like, walk in, bro. Free slime, for real. After Chrome, we were a little parched. You know that means it's Erewhon time. It was busy as usual. We headed to the nearest one and then we tried their mango smoothies. I forgot the name.
All right. I would have to give it a 9 out of 10. It's pretty good. $19 is crazy, but we got this shit for free, so.
Yup.
Yeah, watch up.
Yeah, like you said, it's fire, but 19, with that taken into consideration, I give it like a 7.8, maybe 8 out of 10.
All right.
It's fire. If this was like a $7 smoothie, I'd be like, all right, it's a 10, but with the price, yeah, it's, all right.
All right.
What's up? We just got the Erewhon smoothie with 57 for all three. Something light with the.
What would you rate it on a scale of 1 to 10?
It's pretty good. It's like really fresh. I think that's the best part about it. It's hella fresh. Tastes pretty good. I don't know about 19 though.
What's the rating, Alex?
The rating?
Yeah.
9.
Nine. Gotcha.
One thing about me, twin, is I'm never gonna give up the secret Erewhon method. After that, we went to Terminal 27. If homegirl came through in these boots, she would like, get it. The store was designed so well and the curation was equally elite. Y Project, Namacheco, Rick, MM6, Satoshi. They had all the niche brands too. You can tell the owners really care a lot about fashion.
It's What's that one here? More Kiko Y Project. Interesting. They have a lot of Y Project here.
This brand is the Inhibitionist has lots of these.
And not drip. There's a difference. This Namacheco bomber was so tough. It just felt so good. Definitely gonna try and catch it on a sale though. Hey, in the office, they're not ready for this Namacheco blazer. Thundercat actually showed up as well, and I don't know if it was his sister or his girl, but we accidentally bumped into each other in one of the Terminal 27 hallways, and I kind of felt obligated to, you know, pay her a compliment. We just locked eyes, and I was like, I like your dog. And she was like, you get fly. And I'm not gonna lie, that low-key made me blush a little bit. I can't fold. Like, it really made my day. Like, getting complimented on an outfit that you took a lot of time and you went outside of the box with, it's a great feeling, you know. After that, I grabbed an interview with the store owner. That will be at the end of this video. And then we flicked up in the courtyard with Goat Grant. Here's how those turned out. Next, we went to the Real Real. They have a lot of cool stuff in there, from watches to sneakers. They even had some crazy grails in there.
Oh, it has buttons though.
This reminds me of the Supreme jacket they dropped.
Mm, with the Supreme.
Yeah, but this one doesn't have the Supreme right there.
I feel like it would be better like with the 20 Supreme. Times Supreme.
Yeah, how much is it?
45.
4,500?
11K retail.
Yeah.
Good deal.
Crazy. Good deal from the Real Real. Bro, you're about to blow up his spot. Say, keep that on the low, bro. CRR was definitely catered towards women, though. So, next up, my favorite store out of the entire trip. Dries Van Noten.
Yeah,
this is an entrance to Dries Van Noten. Yeah, but this is a lovely walk-in, bro, I can't lie. And you have to ring a doorbell? That's tough. The Dries store is basically like a super big mansion. It has stairs, rooms, and everything is furnished super nicely. It had a ton of oddities too.
Little fit check.
So I bought these Dries pants in 48 black wool version, the belted cargos on Essence. I'm about to try them on at Dries LA and see how they fit. Really pairs well with the Kiko set. I got the pants in. They're so crazy. I love the shape, but Dries is really known for his patterns.
Yeah, the patterning on Dries. Yeah. Sequins, knitted butterfly pattern.
Is like funky, bro. What's going on with this strap? Okay, here we go. How does it look? I'm wearing it backwards. Like a
normal. Looks good, it's calm. Yeah.
It has a good shoulder drop, bro. I wish all bags came with like a strap this long.
Yeah.
Right,
bag was cool in terms of shoulder drop, but for me personally, I would need a lot bigger bag. I tried on these Dries Van Noten skirt pants as well. I actually had these in my Essence wish list, and as soon as I tried them on and they fit elitely, I just had to cop them right off there.
How does it fit?
They fit amazing, bro. I took like a picture, I'll show you. After Dries, we went to Stussy. I've been looking at these leather blue Stussy pants because they're low-key and affordable alternative to the Bottega leather printed denim. After that, the employee said, no filming. And it had me weak because like, bro, it's Stussy, like what? Everything in the store is literally on your website, but whatever. Anyways, after that, we hit Union LA. There was nothing too noteworthy, but there was this cool Capitol bomber.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
But after trying it on, I think I would have preferred it in just a solid black. It has a really great fit. Oh, and here's what we wore that day. I almost forgot.
Do I just do a breakdown?
Yeah, breakdown, bro. This is
I got the KK jacket. The interviews by the river, bro, Kiko so pants, and the Asics.
Okay.
And the bag.
And the hat, bro.
And the hat, yep.
I need that bag, but I need it for the low.
Yeah. I got the reversible needles AUG today. Same unreleased Fugazi hat. White tee, little chrome accessories, Acne jeans, and Balenciaga.
Okay.
Big step in.
After that, we went to the Grove.
It's a nice little vibe, though. Christmas time is super fire. They got like huge Christmas trees and like they pump out fake snow and stuff.
Fake snow is
for,
crazy.
All the kids that can't experience.
Nah.
And Grant was trying to put me onto this Sando, but the cashier was also trying to put me onto this pizza. So I was like, let's just get the pizza. And I can't lie, the pizza was bussin', respectfully. We then walked around the Grove for a bit. We hit Apple and then Nordstrom's.
Which one?
Regular Acne.
Yeah, but they're probably charging way too much for that. I feel like this pink shirt really go with a lot.
After that, me and Grant decided to hit up Venice Beach to get some flicks in. They turned out so crazy. Like, tell me Grant is not goated with the cam, bro. Why were you wearing shoes? Because it was spontaneous, my guy. My JLL Hokas did get super soaked.
Dude, they're like sweating. Water inside, but like my sock is soaked. Yes. Got salty scarf. I wonder what they're gonna be like when they dry, because like the new buck over here used to be like super buttery, but I don't
know. Yeah, it might get a little crusty.
Whatever, nothing you can't fix, bro, with the brush.
But as you can see, we're all good now. And yeah, after that, I went home and passed out. After that, we ended the trip with zero consumerism. Toured LA and we hit the Huntington Garden. I really recommend there, it's pretty relaxing. And it's a great way to clear your mind while going for a stroll. But yeah, that was my unhinged shopping trip in LA. Thank you guys so much for watching. You guys really make all of this possible. That's so cliche. But yeah, thank you. If you like the video, like the video. And if you like me and want more content, be sure to subscribe. Appreciate y'all.
They don't want to say your name, none of that?
I don't know. If you could do it in the more like mysterious way, that would be cool. I mean, everybody knows I own the store, but yeah.
All right. So I'm here with the owner of Terminal 27. And I just wanted to ask you a few questions about how it's like, how you got to this point. So my first question is, how'd you really get into fashion?
Man, I got into fashion really young. Pretty much like from my upbringing, I did some stuff. Like being a kid who grew up in like LA and stuff, you always, you know, stop by the stores. You're always a skater and you always kind of stop by like La Brea, Fairfax. And you see all the old heads like evolve and level up from just traditional streetwear all the way up to like luxury goods. And I was always kind of like infatuated with the idea of like, you know, dressing nice and like how that was representative of you as a person. And I think like my progression as it as kind of like a student of the game always came from, you know, working with these people, looking up to them and seeing how like, you know, their styles evolved over time, and like you unlock new levels, like, you know, levels to the shit
for real.
Where you go from like a $30 like Stussy t-shirt to like, you know, buying like a Dior like pair of denim, which was like what I remember like vaguely in my head as being like the goal, to get like a pair of DO2 like denim from Dior. And I think it was always just like that natural progression, and I think my upbringing just allowed it. It was just like a natural rise to, you know, eventually opening our own thing. Because we worked for plenty of people in Los Angeles, but growing into, you know, everybody wants to be their own boss and do their own thing, and that's what we kind of like ended up becoming.
Got you. And so, what would you say was the biggest obstacles when you were creating the store?
Money, right?
Yeah.
Money's, especially doing something in LA where, you know, things are super expensive. I mean, when you're a multi-brand store and you're spending, you know, close to $500,000 every 6 months on new product, and then you also have the obstacle of making sure you sell that product to have more money. It's just a recycle kind of thing, you know, like your business has to be successful, I mean, as with any other business, to keep the business going, to get new stuff in, because we don't have our own brand, you know. So I buy all this, everything you see in the store we have to buy. So I think that's the biggest obstacle, because the ideas are there, the creativity is there, but I mean, as for many people, like whatever profession they might be in, money is definitely the only obstacle stopping you from achieving these things, you know?
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Yeah. So like when you're sourcing the brands that you want to sell here, right? How does that process look like?
Man, so I mean, the majority of the buy is done by my fiance, who's also here, but like a lot of it is understanding who, I mean, the first season is really just choosing what you like, right? And then you start understanding who comes to the store. You know, is it you guys? Is it like, what do you guys like? Oh, you guys took to the Nabachecka rack, right?
Yep.
But that isn't every single client we have, you know? I mean, luckily, like, we have a reference point of another person here that liked that rack and tried that stuff on as well. But you really evolve to, I guess it starts from, okay, would we wear this? And it's like, okay, cool. But do we, who else do we have as a client? Like, we think of these archetype people in our head, like, who's shopping at a store? A lot of the people are kind of buying these fits for a one and done use, you know? And then the second portion is like people are just trying to find something different because LA is so saturated with people carrying the same brands.
Exactly.
So how are you different from them? And how do you offer the people who shop here something else that they wouldn't see down the street?
Exactly.
So I think that's the two kind of verticals and or ways that we kind of source stuff is like, you know, one, would we wear it? And two, like, is there a client for it that is our client? Because we want to cater to the people who have been coming here now for the past 2-3 years.
Gotcha. Yeah. Okay. This next one is going to be, like, the cliche question where people would say, what would you give advice to, like, a different person? But I'm going to flip it.
Yeah.
What would you give, like, to your younger self as advice, knowing what you know now?
Oh, shit. Man. I think about this a lot, too. Honestly, there's not much I would change because, like, both me and my girl come from a place where, like, we, you know, we risked it in New York for a year.
Yeah.
Couch hopping and stuff like that. And, like, all of these things, like, gave me the grit because we were broke, like, 6 years ago, you know, which is crazy to think about, right? So, like, I would honestly tell myself, I guess one thing that I do regret is I feel like I live life in like fast forward because I have to constantly be going and there's constantly so many things that are reliant on me to succeed as any business owner. you need to be successful or you're done, right? Yeah. Like, this is your source of income and stuff. So I honestly think, like, because when I try to think back, I wish I took more time to, like, sulk in those moments that were, like, very formative. Because I think back and I'm like, I can barely remember anything. All I do is remember what's going on now and maybe, like, a few months behind. But my memory is so jacked because, like, everything was done so quickly and, like, in a state of, like, high stress. So it's, like, almost trauma.
Yeah, no, I totally understand.
You know, so
that,
it's almost trauma at this point that your brain doesn't want to remember.
Gotcha.
You know, so I think that's one thing that I would do is kind of try to, like, live in the moment a little bit more, which I still don't. I mean, like, we're having a kid in 2 months,
okay,
so I think that'll...
Congratulations,
thank you.
Hope it goes well.
I think that will allow us to, like, okay, really start thinking about things and absorbing things for what it should be, you know, and, like, really kind of basking in the moments and the success and everything,
All right. That's it for me. Thank you.
Appreciate it, man. Yo.
Nice to meet you, man.
Solid questions for off the dome.
Thank you.
Yeah.